lives here. You won't survive.
You met him by the tree.
She met him by the tree.
Maybe it's a sign, the tree.
What's he trying to tell you?
He's waiting for you by the tree.
Sigmund's sister trades shapes with a sorceress, and in disguise, she lies with her own brother. She gives birth to a son named Sinfjotli. After a time, she sends him to the forest to Sigmund. He tests the boy and finds him strong and fearless, and so they go to take their vengeance on King Siggeir. But luck is not on their side. They're captured, and Siggeir has them buried alive. As Sigmund and Sinfjotli are being buried alive, Sigmund's sister throws an armful of straw into the grave mound. Hidden in the straw is Sigmund's sword, the gift of Odin. They cut their way out of the grave mound and set fire to Siggeir's hall. The king burns to death. Sigmund calls to his sister to come out so that she may live and be honored. She does come out, but only to tell him the truth. But she had slept with him, her brother, to beget a strong avenger. "I am not fit to live," she says, and walks back into the fire. Strike vengeance from your heart, Senua, as there is always a heavy price to pay.
Imagine a
sword that can slay gods. Its name is Gramr. It was forged by the god of all Northmen, Odin, and gifted to Sigmund, a great warrior.
I need this sword. It's important. Can you help me?
The sword appears whole, but it is an illusion. It shattered into shards long ago. It is said a great warrior can reforge Gramr by answering the trials of Odin, one for each shard. The roots of the Tree of Death will take you to new lands where you will face the trials.
Go to the shards. Go to the shard.
Go to the shards.
What's the shard? Find it.
The metal runestones.
It's in front of you.
Find it.
The metal.
The runes. You need that sword.
Go to the shard.
Find the shards. Where is it?
Find it. There it is.
Focus.
A king in the north forced the dwarves to make a sword that would never fail and never rust, and that would slice through iron and stone and bring victory to its bearer. But the angry dwarves cursed it. It would be the death of a man every time it was drawn, and it would be the death of the king. Let me tell you about the sword Tyrfing.
I don't recognize this place.
Where are we? Where is she? It feels wrong. Where are we now? Burial mound.
Senua, you remind me of a story that the Northmen tell about a young woman warrior. Her name is Hervor, the daughter of a berserker born after he was killed. She's a wild, willful child who teaches herself to fight with weapons. When she learns where her father is buried, her only desire is to reclaim the treasure buried with him, but above all, the sword, Tyrfing.
I'm here for the trials, like when we first met, remember? I'll find him.
What's that? Did you hear that?
Nothing.
Was that voices?
Is that his voice or the voice of the dead?
Not Dillian.
Dillian's calling to you. Can
Where
you hear
is he? Where is he?
He sounds like he's getting further away.
Hervor disguises herself as a man to join a band of warriors, and soon becomes their leader. When they come to the island where her father is buried, her men do not want to go ashore. They say that evil haunts the island, and that it is a worse place by day than other places are by night. Fearless, she lands alone. There are many grave mounds, and all of them have ghostly flames burning over them. She comes to the grave mound of her father after passing through these ghostly fires as though they were mist. The flames I passed through were real enough. Damn the Northmen to hell.
Turn back. She has to keep going. It's not safe here. She has to keep going. If you go down there, no one can see.
I can hear him.
Within the burial mound, Hervor calls on her father to wake from death and bring her his sword. She says that it is not seemly for the dead in their grave mounds to bear valuable weapons. Her father answers with words of warning. You go to your doom. Baleful runes surround you. You have gone mad. You have lost your mind. Your thoughts are confused. It is dangerous to wake the dead. Like I said, she reminds me of you.
I'm leaving. I've decided. I think it will be good for me.
It's the darkness. It's speaking through.
No, Dad, it's me. I think I can beat it. In my own way.
I can see the darkness in your eyes, child.
I met a boy.
Boy.
The chief fencer.
No.
He said he could help me.
It's a trick.
He said I could be normal.
Normal?
Yes.
No boy is going to save you. No one can. When they see the rot growing inside you,
no.
They will turn their back on you. The gods can only fix you through my hand. You're going nowhere.
No.
You will not defy the gods.
Come, child, take my hand. Come, Senua.
I am leaving!
You cannot escape the darkness. Your curse will make everyone suffer. You will have blood on your hands!
Tell you a story about a god of the Northmen called Baldur. The second son of Odin, he was beautiful, good, and wise. He was fair of feature, he spoke fair words, he gave fair judgments. Light shone from him, only good things were told of him. Yet he was the first of the gods to die. This story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her son. One by one, they each make their vow. Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Didion is in there. Don't forget.
You can feel it. You need the runes to fight Dillion. You need Dillion. He's waiting for you.
He always said he would wait.
He's close. He loves you. Love calling you. Dillion. Dillion, we're here.
Dillion.
Dillion.
There he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through
before he disappears.
Dillion, don't lose him.
Away too many times.
You always let him disappear.
Dillion, there he is.
Quick.
Where is he?
Where's he going?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
He's not in this world.
He's in the other one.
He's in the other one.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillion taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senno explored new paths into the unknown.
The gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
Not in this world.
No. Not in this world. You can't.
Dillion saved you.
stroked your hair, do you remember the way he felt? He was the only one that really loved her. He did love her. Remember the way he looked?
He saved you.
That's you.
He cared in a way that nobody else did. Do you?